White House seeks to downplay social media post in which president claims he had to fire Michael Flynn because he lied to the vice president and FBI Donald Trump. AP Donald Trump is facing claims that a tweet about the firing of his former national security advisor Michael Flynn could amount to obstruction of justice, with one former government ethics official saying it could end his presidency. Responding to Mr. Flynn's guilty plea for lying to the FBI as part of the federal investigation into possible links between his presidential campaign and Russia, Mr. Trump tweeted, "I had to fire General Flynn because he lied to the vice president and the FBI. It is a shame because his actions during the transition were lawful. There was nothing to hide." Critics jumped on the social media post, claiming it appeared to suggest that Mr. Trump knew that Mr. Flynn had lied to investigators before he was forced out of the administration in February. The president then allegedly encouraging the head of the FBI to drop the investigation into Mr. Flynn. Mr. Flynn was interviewed by the FBI on the 24th of January and he admitted in a Washington, D.C. courtroom earlier this week that he had made false statements at that time about his contact in December with then-Russian ambassador to the U.S., Sergey Kislyak. He discussed U.S. sanctions with the ambassador on the 29th of December, the week before he spoke about a United Nations vote on Israel. Mr. Flynn admitted to originally telling the FBI that he did not do so. "I had to fire General Flynn because he lied to the vice president and the FBI. He has pled guilty to those lies. It is a shame because his actions during the transition were lawful. There was nothing to hide." Donald J. Trump at Real Donald Trump. December 2, 2017. Mr. Flynn resigned from the Trump administration on the 13th of February after it emerged he had also given inaccurate statements to Vice President Mike Pence about his interactions with Mr. Kislyak. Former FBI Director James Comey subsequently testified in front of Congress that Mr. Trump told him during the 14th of February meeting at the White House that he hoped Mr. Comey could let this go in regards to the investigation of Mr. Flynn. The former director of the U.S. Office of Government Ethics, Walter Schaub, was quick to suggest the tweet might have ended any other presidential administration, just couldn't resist commenting on Flynn. "Are you admitting you knew Flynn had lied to the FBI when you asked Comey to back off Flynn?" https://t.coglove99f. Walter Schaub at Walt Schaub. December 2, 2017. "Before we slipped into an alternate universe of unabashed corruption, this tweet alone might have ended a presidential administration." Walter Schaub at Walt Schaub. December 2, 2017. "Knowing that Mr. Flynn lied while pressuring the FBI drop an investigation could potentially be seen as obstruction of justice," according to critics, including California Democrat Representative Ted Lieu. "This is obstruction of justice. At POTUS now admits he knew Michael Flynn lied to the FBI. Yet Trump tried to influence or stop the FBI investigation on Flynn." https://t.co8jakeigsguo, Ted Lieu at Ted Lieu. December 2, 2017. A lawyer for Mr. Trump, Mark Kasowitz, strongly denied Mr. Comey's claim at the time it was made. He told the Washington Post the president never in form or substance directed or suggested that Mr. Comey stop investigating anyone, including the president never suggested that Mr. Comey, quote, let Flynn go, close quote. Mr. Trump has consistently denied any collusion with Russia and has labeled the investigation a witch hunt. Mr. Comey was fired from his position in May by Mr. Trump and special counsel Robert Mueller was appointed to take over the investigation. It originally began as a probe into Russian meddling in the 2016 presidential election, which a number of U.S. intelligence agencies believe was aimed at aiding Mr. Trump, but has grown to include a number of other areas. It is believed that potential obstruction of justice is an area Mr. Mueller and his team are looking into as part of the Russia probe. However, it would likely not have been difficult for those in the White House to discern that Mr. Flynn was potentially under investigation, with Acting Attorney General Sally Yates telling White House counsel Don McGahn on the 26th of January, 2 days after Mr. Flynn's FBI interview, that he had discussed sanctions with Mr. Kislyak. Ms. Yates also said that she had told Mr. McGahn that Mr. Flynn had been interviewed by the FBI but did not characterize what Mr. Flynn had told investigators. As for Mr. Trump's tweet today about Mr. Flynn, Trump administration officials have sought to play down its significance. The Washington Post reported that the tweet was potentially drafted by Trump lawyer John Doe, citing sources, while other officials called the tweet simply sloppy. After Mr. Flynn's guilty plea to the one charge of lying to the FBI, the White House also sought to distance Mr. Trump. "Nothing about the guilty plea or the charge implicates anyone other than Mr. Flynn," Ty Cobb, the White House lawyer, said in a statement. Donald Trump insists no collusion after Michael Flynn admits lying to FBI. Mr. Flynn is the first official within the Trump administration to be charged in relation to the investigation, but is the fourth person connected to the Trump campaign. In October, Mr. Trump's former campaign manager, Paul Manafort, and his associate Rick Gates were charged with 12 counts of financial crimes related to their work in Ukraine. At the same time, Mr. Mueller revealed foreign policy adviser George Papadopoulos had pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about contacts with Russia-linked individuals, a similar charge that Mr. Flynn admitted to as part of the plea deal. More about Donald Trump. Michael Flynn: reuse content. We use cookies to enhance your visit to our site and to bring you advertisements that might interest you. Read our privacy and cookie policies to find out more.